Extra late start this morning. Had some killer conversation with Dad Dog. He's an addiction physician. He used to do family medicine and now he does addiction. And yeah, we talked for over an hour. It was a killer conversation, dude. I really appreciate it. It was a pleasure to meet you. All right, getting a really late start. 11:45. Had a lot of good conversation this morning. It was hard to get anything done. Shooting for Kent, still like 14 miles away. I thought it was closer than that. I thought it was like 6 miles. I don't know how I messed that up. Thought I'd be able to get into the post office and get out today, but might have to camp somewhere around there. We'll see when we get there. I don't know how far I am from Harper's Ferry, but I do know that these shoes are lasting a lot longer than I'm used to. Had to cut a little piece of tread off the bottom that was flapping yesterday or day before. Nothing big. But that toe cap is coming, you know, undone, but it's still folding upward. It's not like a problem catching on nothing. No rippage or busting in the inner arch like I usually get within 300-400. Thinking maybe I just got a good pair, or maybe Ultra's taking some suggestions. Kind of messed up. Thought Kent was only like 5 or 6 from the shelter. It was actually like 14, 15. I realized once I got going this morning, I got a package at the post office, but don't believe I'm gonna make it before they close. The issue is I ate all my snacks last night because I was planning on getting more snacks today around midday. So, thinking I might attempt to stealth camp somewhere in Kent. I know that's some nice folks over there with some nice property, so they'll probably frown on it, but I promise I'll pick up my mess. What's up, little guy?
Baby.
Alright, y'all. Have a good one.
Thought we were already in Connecticut. Well, I said I was out of snacks, but I forgot I had these bad boys.
Getting close.
I remember my buddy Nick that was gonna come out, and his girlfriend came out here in 21. Met me in camp. We had supper, and then they dropped me off back here on trail around 9, 10 o'clock that night. That's some kind of detour in place. Sign says follow the blazes on the road. Definitely walked through that field in 21, right up that mountain. Well, on the bright side of this detour, I have a much shorter walk to get back to trail. This is where we're getting back on. Well, I'd love to have one of them jutes. About to hit this $2 shower and drip dry. At least this little spot's keeping the wind out. Well, that was enjoyable. The drip dry wasn't as bad as I thought either. It looks nice.
Hi there.
How you doing?
Good, thank you.
I can't. Now, why would you lock the bathrooms? Yeah, the ankle's doing good. It was good, like, as soon as I woke up. It just felt a little weird the rest of the day after the fall. But, like, in high school, I used to do that, like, every few months, like, so bad. I would get this black baseball on the side of my ankle, like half of a baseball poking out of the ankle. You know what I mean? I had to use like crutches to go to school a few times, the first few times at least. But I feel like I've stretched the ligaments out in both ankles at this point so many times that they can bounce back pretty quick. I hope. Yeah, I guess I like relate everything back to skateboarding because it's really like the only like real physical thing I got into and stayed into for a long time in my life, you know? And so it's just natural for me to like compare and contrast the two.